Hey, what is up, everyone? This is Adam with Nostalgic Adam, and today I have another sweet unboxing. Inside of this box is the Child Build-A-Bear plush. I purchased this at the end of April, and they shipped it out within a few days, and I finally got them in today. And now we're going to open them up. And I'll do a nice little unboxing review and a comparison as well. All right. I like how there's no doesn't show what's in the box. That's nice. I thought they were going to kind of ship it in a in this Build-A-Bear iconic little carry house. I think that's what it is. But starting off, little peephole for him right there. This slides right on out. Come on. There we go. Get rid of that. Okay. All right. So this is the iconic Build-A-Bear looking box. So we are in quarantine right now. This must be the certificate. So we're in quarantine right now if you are watching this. And Build-A-Bear and everything else is closed, as you know. So we cannot go into the Build-A-Bear stores and actually pick up and stuff this child ourselves. So they when you order them, they come pre-stuffed. And it comes with, I believe, 5 different voice changes. So the total price for everything shipped voice changes, and it's all as a bundle. You can't take out voice changes and add voice changes. It comes out to $64.99 shipped, which isn't bad, honestly. So I saw this, and I knew it was going to be super limited, and I know that it's going to be one of those collectibles down the line that's going to be sought after. So I had to pick him up. So this is what the top of the box looks like. Open this up right here. For those of you that don't know, oh, this must be his head. Oh, he's all bundled up. For those of you that don't know, Build-A-Bear is an awesome company that you can walk into their store and you can stuff and fill up a teddy bear, basically. So they have all different kinds. They have they've had zebras and alligators and Pokemon, Pikachu, and Bulbasaur, Charmander, and all that stuff. So they have a whole bunch of different things, and they even have Star Wars themed characters as well. So you could go into this store, and you basically choose the bear that you want, and you can start stuffing. Oh shoot, this is cool! And you can stuff your actual Build-A-Bear friend. A galaxy of fun awaits you and your new friend. This curious quarry is known as the Child. Protect this adorable alien at all costs and give it a bounty of hugs. That's cool. I really like this. This is awesome. A cool little take home. So let's open it up and let's bring them on out. All right. Nothing in that box right there. Put that down there. All right. So they bundled him up with his little vest tunic thing all the way up towards his face, covering his face. Bring that on down. Oh man, he's cute. Look at that. Oh. So there are so many different versions of the Child. Let's figure out how to should Velcro this. So this is one of my favorite ones. My absolute is the Mattel Vinyl Head Plush one's my absolute favorite one. And I saw this one, and I like Build-A-Bear. I've had good experiences with Build-A-Bear as a kid growing up. So I had to get this one as well, and I knew it was going to be a collectible. So. Just up nice to have. We'll put it on the plushy couch. Okay, out of the box. This is the Child, and this is what he looks like. Got a nice Star Wars logo. It's kind of like a little bit of a vinyl printed, ironed-on type of material right here on his foot. Extremely soft, super, super soft. His feet are exposed right here, and he's got a brown little baby jumper on right there, which is pretty cool. His clothing material is a nice, I guess that Velcro's there. I guess that one could Velcro like that. His tunic garb is a nice, soft, cottony type of material. Comes out and it's got a kind of like an imitation kind of looking wool, type of material here. And that's also on his little wrist cuffs and this wrist cuff as well. His hands actually have the sound speakers in them right now. So we'll give those a play in a second. Looking at his face, super cute, super, super cute. Got those nice dark eyes with the little brown outlay right there. Beautiful green color. Nice pink attention to detail of the ears. Sweet stitching right there. Awesome. I love this Build-A-Bear. And this is one that's going to be definitely a collectible. So if you have a chance to get it, and if you're remotely or mildly interested in it, definitely pick it up. Super cool. $64.99. Here's the tag right here. I probably won't be taking this off. I'll keep this on there. And it has the logo, Build-A-Bear, Mandalorian, made with love, and who it came from. Right there, the child, Disney. Very cool. All right, so his hands aren't, or his arms aren't posable, so they flop down when you bring them, when you let go of them. His ears aren't posable. They have a little bit of you can kind of play around with them a bit, but they don't stay in whatever position you decide to put them in. They kind of fall forward. There's no metal band or wire or anything in there. He's got stitching on his nose right here, and maybe missing a little bit of stitching there. Maybe. Oh, yeah. Might be missing a little bit of stitching right there. Yeah. So that one's got one on that side. That one might be missing it. Unless it's super buried under here, which I don't see it. But that's okay. He's got mouth stitching right here across. And nice. Oh, I like what they did with the stitching to give his forehead that kind of older looking appearance. We can kind of what we can do is we can kind of play with his eyelids a little bit to make his eyes pop a little bit more. Oh yeah, that looks a lot cuter. So you can kind of move around, move this eyelid material around to kind of make him look a little bit more cute. So let's get into the voice, the sounds. So if I believe it is 5 sounds, so we'll check it out. So on his right arm right here, it has the Build-A-Bear stamps or stitching, that nice little logo. And we're going to squeeze his hand and see what kind of sounds come out. So that's the first one. That's cute. That's the second one. Okay, I think that's the third. Make sure that wasn't the first one over again. Okay, that one's he's still going. The fourth, and a little laugh. That's cool. Oh, shoot, he's still going. And that's the fifth one. I do feel something on this side. What is this? Oh. That is cool. Okay, so on his left hand, he has his left little paw. He has the Mandalorian theme song. That is freaking cool. That's awesome. I don't remember them saying that they were doing that. So that's awesome. Maybe I didn't read all the way. I just wanted to get him in my cart as quickly as I could. So that's cool. Okay, so he does have 5 sounds, and then he does have the Mandalorian theme song right there. Super cute. He's getting more and more adorable as I keep playing with him. Obviously, his likeness isn't as true. I mean, it's pretty true to the character, but it's not like a sideshow character. So I mean, it's a stuffed animal, and I think it's great. I think it's cute. Kids will like this. I like this. So I think this is super cool, super cute to have. Okay, so that is him sitting right there. Let's see if you can get him to sit a little bit better. He might be a little top heavy, but I can probably move him around a little bit. Oh, he's falling over. Okay, so let's look at this. I believe it gave his height on here. I think it's like 14 inches. Yes, 14 inches, 10 ounces. It's your eye color black, fur color light green. That's nice. That's cool. I like this little certificate. You could frame this if you wanted to. Very cool. Awesome. Okay, so let's compare him to our Vinyl Head Mattel plush set that I picked up as well. And we'll do a little compare and contrast. I know the price differences are not the same by any scheme, but we can at least do a little bit of a compare and contrast. So Mattel Vinyl Head plush stands tall at 11 inches. The child Build-A-Bear stands tall at 14 inches. So I am guessing they are going off of this height right here if we were to actually stand him up, which seems pretty accurate because if the child is 11 inches here, the vinyl head plush, then he's not too much taller than that. So I would say that is accurate, a good 4 inches. Let me see if I have my measuring tape here. I think I do. We'll do a nice little measure. Okay. Measure this out to 14 inches. Okay. Move you over here, little buddy. Okay. Kind of stand him up. If you can see that on camera right there. There we go. Yeah, it's 14. That's it. That is about 14 inches standing tall. So that's great. That's accurate. That's really cool. Okay, so the price points, this child right here is $64.99. That is shipped to your house. This child right here from Mattel is $24.99, available at Target and Walmart. This child right here has the vinyl head plush and an amazing sculpt with some awesome attention to detail with paint schemes and the sculpt around his head to kind of give those wrinkles. The Build-A-Bear head is obviously a plush material that you would fill in with the stuffing if you were to go into the actual Build-A-Bear store itself. The Mattel's tunic garb is a softer type of burlap. You see that right there with some awesome stitching. And it's got like that little wool color material right there as well. The Build-A-Bear is a little bit of, is definitely a softer material. And the cuffing is the same color as the entire tunic, and it is a lot softer. I would say this one is more true to the film's scale and what they use, and this one is more of a playful, fun, soft material. No sounds come out of the Mattel vinyl head plush. He doesn't speak, but that's okay. The child in the series didn't speak yet either. He just made noises, as you heard with this Build-A-Bear. This Build-A-Bear comes with 5 different voice changes and the Mandalorian theme song right there. And soft hands, vinyl hands here. We have legs on this Build-A-Bear, and then we have no legs, but like a little round stump on the Mattel plush to keep him stable. There's also beans in here, little bean bags. And that helps keep him leveled and gives him some weight so he can kind of sit still. There are no beans in this Build-A-Bear right here. It is just your plushy material, little tush tag right there. And he will sit down. He'll sit down with a little bit of play. Okay. I am absolutely in love with this Build-A-Bear, the child. I think for the cost, it's not bad. I would like to go in the store and actually build this Build-A-Bear myself. Just it's part of the experience. You get to go in there. You get to choose this empty body shell of a Build-A-Bear. Go up to the nice man or lady at the stuffing station. You give them your bear, and then they go through like this whole spiel where you get to do a dance and make a wish, and you get to put some hearts in the Build-A-Bear, and then you get to stuff your Build-A-Bear to your liking. You can go super firm, or you can go super soft. They did like a medium here, so there is a little bit of play, and he's not super like stiff anywhere. So he is kind of, you know, a little bit more, I would say, able to love on, I guess, you know? So then once you're done with that, you get to go over to this, this washing station, and you get to wash your Build-A-Bear and clean your Build-A-Bear. And then you get to name your Build-A-Bear, name it whatever you want. And then that's when they print out that certificate that we have down there. So overall, I would say this is an amazing grab. If you are mildly entertained by this Build-A-Bear, grab it while you can. I know they did the second wave of online orders, today. Oh, no, I'm sorry, not today. They did it over the weekend on Saturday, I believe. They did the second wave of orders where you would basically sit in a virtual waiting room, and they give you a time limit, and they say, you know, your estimated time is an hour, and you can, if their quantity isn't sold out by the time your name gets selected, then you have a chance to order the child, which I think is a very smart and fair idea. That way there's not a bunch of people that come in and they start ordering you know, tens of hundreds of childs, and then nobody can get one, and then they're on the aftermarket for $130, which they are right now. So sign up for their newsletter, and they'll send you an email when the child is going to drop again. Overall, great buy. I love it. I as many of the child merchandise as I can get, I'm going to probably most likely get. Just because I'm in love with the Mandalorian series. I think it's a tremendous Star Wars series that we haven't seen before, and it dives into different characters and different things that, you know, are on the sidelines. So anything Mandalorian, I most likely will pick that up. Other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I have an Instagram. Be sure to check it out. It's Nostalgic Adam, all one word. Give it a like, give it a follow. I do a lot of toy photography, reviews, live openings, and just all sorts of toy things. And once quarantine is over, I will be doing more toy hunts and filming things like that. So other than that, we're going to play the theme song one last time, and then I will see y'all in the next video. All right, take care, guys.